Today we are going to start a new topic of the chapter 4, that is thermometer. As we have learned in the last video, temperature. Temperature means it is a reliable measure of degree of hotness and coldness. But we can't measure the temperature, exact temperature of any substance just by touching. So there is a device which is used to measure the temperature. It is known as thermometer. So we will discuss about thermometer. Thermometer means, as we have discussed, a device which is used to measure the temperature. It is known as thermometer. By using the thermometer, we can measure the exact temperature of any substance. Now, basically, there are two types of thermometer, clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Clinical thermometer, it is used to measure the temperature of humans and animals body. And laboratory thermometer, it is used to measure the temperature of any other object, any other means other than humans and animals. And you can find this laboratory thermometer in the school lab. So basically there are two types of thermometer we use, clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Other types of thermometer are also available, like alcohol thermometer, digital thermometer, and nowadays we use digital thermometer. Now we will discuss about clinical thermometer in detail. Now our next topic is clinical thermometer. Clinical thermometer means a thermometer which is used to measure the temperature of animals. Clinical thermometer means a thermometer which is used to measure the temperature of animals and humans body. It is known as clinical thermometer. Clinical thermometer we can't use for measuring the temperature of any other object. Only we can measure the temperature of humans and animals body by this thermometer. So clinical thermometer, it is invented by Sir Thomas Clifford Allbutt in 1866. The range of clinical thermometer, it is 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius, and on the Fahrenheit scale there is 94 degrees Fahrenheit to 108 degrees Fahrenheit. As we have learned in the last video, different types of temperature scale for measuring the temperature: Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale and Kelvin scale. So the range of Celsius scale on the clinical thermometer, that is 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius, and on the Fahrenheit scale, that is 94 degrees Fahrenheit to 108 degrees Fahrenheit. Now structure of a clinical thermometer. You can see in the diagram the structure of a clinical thermometer. The clinical thermometer, it is formed of a long and narrow glass tube. This is a completely glass tube, and the one end of this glass tube there is a bulb. This bulb, it is filled by mercury. Mercury, it is a metal which is liquid at a room temperature, and it is filled in the bulb of the clinical thermometer. Now you can see inside the glass tube there is a very thin tube. This thin tube, it is known as capillary tube. Inside the capillary tube also mercury is filled. Now you can see this is a scale, this is a Celsius scale which is present on the clinical thermometer, and the range of Celsius scale on the clinical thermometer, that is 35 to 42 degree Celsius. And you can see there are two bigger lines are there, and between the bigger lines 10 small divisions are there, and one smaller division, it is indicate 1 degree Celsius. So the range of clinical thermometer, it is 35 degree to 42 degree Celsius. And above the bulb you can see there is a kink. The role of kink, the use of kink in the clinical thermometer, because when we measure the temperature by using a clinical thermometer, and after taking out from the mouth and from the underarms, we have to give the jerk, and this kink, this prevent the falling of mercury, because when we take out the thermometer from our mouth, so this kink, it prevents the falling of mercury from its level. So the role of kink in the clinical thermometer, it is very very important. So this is the structure of a clinical thermometer. Now our next topic is using a clinical thermometer. How can we use a clinical thermometer in our daily life? So the first step for using a clinical thermometer, that is wash and dry the thermometer. For washing the thermometer, generally we use an antiseptic solution. एंड ड्राई ऑलवेज वी ड्राई द क्लिनिकल थर्मामीटर विद अ ड्राई क्लोथ बिफोर एंड आफ्टर एवरी यूज. सो वॉश विद अ एंटीसेप्टिक सॉल्यूशन एंड ड्राई विद अ क्लीन क्लोथ बिफोर एंड आफ्टर एवरी यूज. नेक्स्ट स्टेप, गिव इट वन और टू जग्स एंड मेक श्योर दैट द मर्करी इन द कैपिलरी ट्यूब हैज फॉलन वेल बिलो 35 डिग्री सेल्सियस. बिफोर यूजिंग वी हैव टू गिव द जग्स लाइक दिस बिकॉज दिस जग दे मेक श्योर द मर्करी इन द कैपिलरी ट्यूब हैज फॉलन वेल बिलो 35 डिग्री सेल्सियस. बिकॉज एज वी डिस्कस द किंक इज प्रेजेंट इन अबाउ द बल्ब एंड दिस किंक इट प्रिवेंट्स द मर्करी लेवल फ्रॉम फॉलिंग बैक फ्रॉम द 35 डिग्री सेल्सियस फ्रॉम when we take out from the patient mouth. So this king it prevents the mercury from falling back when we take out from the patient mouth. So before using we have to give the jugs so the mercury it can fall below from the 35 degree Celsius. So we can use again. Next is say put the bulb of the thermometer under the tongue. Now next is say that is put the bulb of the thermometer under the tongue of the patient. Next, take it out and read the temperature. After the then we take out the thermometer and read the temperature of the patient body. And now these are using a clinical thermometer. Clinical thermometer, as we have discussed, the range of clinical thermometer is 35 degree Celsius and 42 degree Celsius, and on the Fahrenheit scale that is 94 degree Fahrenheit to 108 degree Fahrenheit. And the normal human body temperature that is 37 degree Celsius. So this 37 degree Celsius, it is the average normal human body temperature, and we take this temperature over a large number of healthy person. That's why it's the average normal human body temperature. Next, we are saying the range of clinical thermometer, it is 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius. And when you suffer from a fever and your parents always measure the temperature and they say the temperature it is 98 degree and 99 and 100 degree, and you might be confused because we are saying the range of clinical thermometer it is 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius, and your parents they never say the temperature is 40 degree Celsius and 38 degree Celsius. Always they measure in the 98, 99 and 100 is because the range of clinical thermometer on the Fahrenheit scale that is 94 degree Fahrenheit to 108 degree Fahrenheit, and the Fahrenheit scale because we are using commonly for measuring the temperature. So always we say the temperature in the Fahrenheit scale that is 98 and 99 and 100 degree Fahrenheit. And we are saying that the temperature that is now our next topic is precautions while using a clinical thermometer. Which precaution we should use when we are using a clinical thermometer? The first precaution that is the thermometer must be washed with an antiseptic solution and dried with a clean dry cloth before and after every use. Next is the thermometer should be given 2 or 3 soft jerks to bring the mercury in the capillary well below 35 degree Celsius. Because as we have discussed above the bulb there is a king and it prevents the mercury from when we take out this thermometer after reading. So this king it prevents the mercury level from falling back. So we have to give the jerks and always this jug, the thermometer should be given 2 or 3 soft jugs to bring the mercury in the capillary well below 35 degree Celsius. And while giving the jugs, the thermometer should not hit any hard object because it can be break. And while giving the jugs, maybe sometime the thermometer hitting any hard object and the mercury it can be released. So for collecting the mercury, and mercury it falls on the floor in the form of a small droplet. So for collecting the mercury, we take a kneaded wheat flour and roll it over the mercury and put this contaminated wheat flour in a polythene bag and tie a knot, and we can give to the nearest pharmacy to the dispose of, because mercury it is a very very poisonous. Next precaution, when we are reading the thermometer and while using the thermometer in the mouth, we should not laugh and we should not yawn and we should not talk, because this time maybe thermometer may be break and the mercury it may be released in the mouth, and mercury it is a very very poisonous and fatal. Once it release in the mouth, it can't be completely removed from our intestine. So we should not laugh and yawn, or we should not talk while reading the thermometer. Next precaution, note the reading in the clear light. Always when we are using the thermometer, always note the reading in a clear light, and we can give some small rotation to make the mercury level clearly visible. Next, keep the level of the mercury along the line of sight while reading the thermometer. When we are reading the thermometer, so always the scales which are present on the clinical thermometer, always it is present in the line of sight while reading the thermometer. And thermometer, we can't use a clinical thermometer for measuring the temperature of any other object. We should not keep the thermometer, clinical thermometer, in the sun, or we should not bring near to the flame, because it may be break. So these are some precautions while using a clinical thermometer. And we are saying the range of clinical thermometer, it is 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius. And because the range of this clinical thermometer, because the human body temperature, it does not go below from 35 degree Celsius and does not rise above 42 degree Celsius. That's why the range of clinical thermometer, it is 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius. And on the Fahrenheit scale, there is 94 degree Fahrenheit to 108 degree Fahrenheit. So these are some precautions while using a thermometer. Thank you for watching my video.